you may already know the basic ways to playback media. So in this video, we're going to cover three additional ways to refine how you review your edits. The first way is play in to out. When you set in and out points within your sequence, or even within your source monitor, when using the shortcut, you can initiate playback to begin at the set in point and end at the set out point. This is helpful when you're working on a specific portion of your timeline and you want to continually play back that portion as you make small adjustments. Now, if you don't have in and out points set or you didn't want to add them and you need to review a small section, play around is a great function. Press Shift plus K and Premiere Pro will play 3 seconds before and after your playhead. So a total of 6 seconds. And this is ideal for perfecting an edit. Just move your playhead near the cut, use play around, tweak and repeat until it looks just right. Now, for some of you, that 3 second padding might just be a bit too long to wait. So it could also work for a group of edits, or I would suggest sticking to play in to out. But this next option is going to power up both of these advanced playback options, which is loop. It's kind of underrated. If you click on the wrench icon, then select loop. I've only toggled it on for the program monitor, which is connected to my timeline. If I wanted to loop a clip, I'll double click it into the source panel. I'll then select the wrench icon again and enable loop. And this is great if you want to watch a clip over and over again, maybe, I guess. But the real power comes when you combine the loop function with play into out and play around playback methods. So for example, if I have in and out points set within my timeline, and now I use play into out, control plus spacebar, then play into out will loop infinitely. And the same goes if I use the play around option. But what's really cool about loop playback in conjunction with these two advanced playback methods is that you can tweak your edit while watching a live preview. And now you have no need to keep hitting play over and over again. It's a simple way to speed up your workflow and make quick, precise adjustments. Now, I think the ultimate way to be using this is finding the edit you want to adjust, setting in and out points, then using the play into out playback option with loop toggled on, and tweak your edit while watching a live preview until you're happy with the result. Okay, I know I said ultimate, but let's crank it up a notch. Go to Edit, Preferences, Playback. At the top of the window, you'll see options for pre-roll and post-roll. This actually allows us to adjust the time playback starts before the playhead, pre-roll, and the time playback happens after the playhead, post-roll. So remember how playaround defaults to 3 seconds before and after? Well, with this new option, we can fine-tune that padding however we want. So once you find your sweet spot, turn on loop, and now you've got a smoother, faster live preview, no in and out points required. All right, now it's your turn. Test out these playback techniques and see how they improve your workflow. Did you learn anything new? Let me know in the comments which one of these options you use the most. Thanks so much for watching, and if you want to learn more, be sure to check out the other videos on my YouTube channel. For longer in-depth learning with projects you actually get to work on, check out my Skillshare page, and the links are all available within the description of this video.